Pleasant weather we're having, Mr. Radcliffe.
Very nice of the time of year, Captain.
You're keeping busy, I hope.
Oh, can't complain.
Remind me, what are you doing here?
You ordered me to be strung up by my thumbs, Captain.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yes, that does sound like me.
And you know, it's so amusing. I can't even remember why. Bye-bye.
I miss him a bit.
The bag's heavy. Here, take this. Whoa. Just take it to the best one, thanks. Lucy Rose for Starling Ward.
Hey. Yeah.
Jersey.
What?
Oh. Might need these.
Okay, off we go.
Yes! She is beautiful!
Oh, hello, Lucy. Back again. Must be the nightlife. See ya.
I'm fine. You can stop worrying. Oh, don't start crying again, Mum. You know you get stuff coming out of your nose. No, it's really attractive. Hi, Lucy.
Hi. Nice to see you again. Will you be staying, Mrs. Rose?
No. Yeah. I'm not a kid anymore. Come back tomorrow.
Why don't you go and put your things in your room?
Sure.
You know where it is?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. How has she been?
Okay. Sometimes I sit by her bed all night just to make sure she's still breathing, but...
Shall I?
Oh, thanks.
That's not going to do much for your own health, is it? You know, Mr. Wiley is a brilliant surgeon. And doesn't he just know it?
It's true.
Go on through.
Mum, I read this ages ago.
How am I supposed to know what book you're reading?
I left it on the bed.
You leave everything on the bed.
Your father emailed.
Mm-hmm.
He sends his love. He wanted to be here, but he can't get back from the States.
He Facebooked me.
Oh.
It's cool. He'll be so guilty, I'll get awesome presents.
Another holiday with the infant girlfriend?
It's his work. You know, he'd be here if he could.
You always defend him.
He's my dad.
Sorry. I'm such a bitch.
Well, duh. What am I gonna read? We could live for a thousand years. But if I hurt you, I'd make wine from your tears. I told you.
Don't go far. Mr. Wiley be here soon.
Okay, so, next trip. What have I got here? Is it a bird? Is it a plane? No, it's a hanky.
Yeah! Oh, that's sick.
Wow, look at the red hanky.
Jersey.
Yeah.
Is there a bigger library anywhere? With grown-up stuff?
There is something you might like. Have you ever visited the museum?
There's nothing that says it's a museum.
You just have to know it's here. Wanted something to read. Here you are.
Peter Pan's for little kids. Saw it years ago.
Did you enjoy it?
I suppose so. Especially the flying. I mean, I know that they were on wires, but it felt real.
The power of the imagination can transform any experience, even a terrible one. You see, Barry's brother died when he was just 14, and Barry comforted his mother by making up stories about a little boy who never grows old. So his lost brother became the immortal Peter Pan. Not a bad way to remember someone you loved.
It's deep.
I was Doctor of Philosophy at the University of Warsaw, so of course it went deep.
It's still a kid's book, though.
I'm sure Rory would like to hear Peter Pan, wouldn't you? Lucy will read it to you. If she's not too grown up, of course.
Later, okay?
Hello. How are you, Lucy?
All right, thank you, Mr. Wiley.
Good, Mrs. Rose, you're well, I hope.
Mustn't grumble. Oh, God. That made me sound about 80, didn't it? Which I'm not.
No, I never thought you were. So, I have a team of students with me today, and I'm sure you're going to be impressed with their knowledge and insight. So, this is Lucy Rose.
Hi, Lucy.
Hi, Lucy.
Hi.
Lucy is going to tell you her symptoms, and one of you is going to tell me what's wrong with her. Okay? Lucy, would you mind?
Of course. Shortness of breath, fainting. Poor weight gain and dizziness. Not all at the same time.
Heart disease.
Really? On a cardiac ward? Are you sure?
Congestive heart failure.
Ballpark.
And Sally?
Congenital heart disease.
Would you care to be more specific? Mr. Malik?
Arrhythmogenic right ventricular cardiomyopathy.
Oh, close. Really, really close.
Yeah, very close. But put them out of their misery, Lucy.
Of course. Tetralogy of Fallot.
Also known as
blue baby syndrome.
Blue baby syndrome, yeah.
As is common with this condition, Miss Rose underwent intracardiac repair at 6 months old. Repairs were also made to widen the pulmonary valve and to increase blood flow to the lungs through the pulmonary arteries. Further treatment, Mr. Yeboah.
Regular checkups and medication.
Any particular kind or just a big jar of get well soon pills?
Captopril, to relax the arteries and decrease the blood pressure. Furosemide as a diuretic.
Mm-hmm. Anything else?
And loads of other stuff I've forgotten.
I have to fail you, I'm sorry. Okay, so our initial operation was a success, but Lucy's recent checkups have shown signs of pulmonary regurgitation and arrhythmia. So pulmonary valve replacement is now urgently required. We operate tomorrow. You will observe. Thank you. Go outside and wait for me. Try not to damage any children. Say goodbye to Lucy.
Bye.
Any questions, Mrs. Rose?
If I could just have a word in private.
Of course. I mean, come on. It's only my heart.
I've been thinking the operation. Mm-hmm. I suppose there really is no alternative. It's just Lucy's been doing so well until recently.
Mrs. Rose, I know. But if we don't perform this operation, she'll die. It's a very good procedure, and it's one that I've performed many times, and her prognosis is excellent. Okay?
It's just, I keep thinking, what if she goes into the operating theater? And never comes out.
Look, I can't pretend that there isn't any risk, but I'm gonna do everything in my power to make sure that doesn't happen. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Now I'm going to go tend to that lot and make sure they're not upsetting the nurses. Okay.
Thank you, Lucy.
Thank you, Mr. Wiley. He's divorced, by the way. Nurse Doyle told me. So, now you can make a move. Mm. Come on, you obviously fancy him.
I did not. He's not allowed. The patient-doctor thing, the Hippocratic Oath.
I bet there's nothing in that about not dating your patient's mum.
Bet there is. And at my age, you don't date, you go on the internet and you trawl through the bigamists and the serial killers.
Stop. Seize the day, mum. You never know if you'll get another chance. And I don't want to think of you on your own if I do have to. Go.
Please, have a seat there.
Sorry.
Oh, no one has to apologize for crying in this place, you know?
You know, I dream about...
No.
A normal life. With normal teenage problems. And no hospitals.
Well, I think in a year or two, you'll be telling Lucy not to stay out all night. In that silly short skirt, life will be too normal.
Oh, God. That would be wonderful.
Hmm. All children except one grow up. They soon know that they will grow up. And the way Wendy knew was this.
What are you reading?
Peter Pan.
Can you read the bit where he gets eaten by a crocodile? That's the best bit. Crocodiles drag you underwater and drown you, and then eat you later. Oh, I'm John, by the way. And this is my stupid brother, Michael.
I'm not stupid, you're stupid.
And the way Wendy knew was this. One day, when she was 2 years old, she was playing in a garden, and she plucked a flower and ran with it to her mother. Mrs. Darling put a hand to her heart and cried. Oh, why can't you remain like this forever?
Is this private? Or can anyone listen?
Can you skip to the good bits?
It won't make sense if I do that.
Of course it will. Everyone knows Peter Pan.
Well, not the way I tell it.
You sit there. They're running around.
It began so uneventfully, so precisely like 100 other evenings, with Nana putting on the water for Michael's bath and carrying him to it on her back.
You're right, mate. Go on. He's okay.
I won't go to bed, he had shouted, like one who still believed he had the last word on the subject.
I won't be made, Nana. I won't. It isn't 6 o'clock yet.
Wendy, John.
Bed.
Not yet.
Mary, I warn you, Mary, that if this tie is not round these children, stop, round my neck. We don't go out to dinner, and we don't go out to dinner with the chairman. I lose my job. Ow!
Not starving children will be thrown out into the street. Who hit me?
No, Nana, no. I don't want a bath.
I sometimes think it's not quite right to have a dog as a nanny. Oh. I think the children are puppies.
I'm sure she knows the difference.
All right. Good night, children.
Night, Papa.
You good for Nana?
Now, this is the part where Peter comes searching for his own shadow.
Wait, could his shadow be a vampire or something?
There aren't any vampires in Peter Pan.
But there could be. And ghosts. And superheroes.
Is Peter Pan an X-Men?
Of course not, stupid.
I'm not stupid.
All right, no ghosts, no vampires, and no X-Men. But there is a fairy. Her name is Tinkerbell. And in the time we've taken to say this, she's rummaged under all the beds, looking for Peter's shadow.
Have you found it, Tink? I did not lose it. It was cut off when their mother closed the window on me.
Bells, you should know, are the fairy language.
I don't think she's ugly at all. I think she's quite pretty. There's my shadow. There you are.
Wendy Moira Angela Darling. Pleased to meet you. Where did you come from?
The Neverland. I can't get my shadow still.
It might have to be sewn.
I had stitches once when I cut my hand. The need was this big.
It wasn't. Anyway, that was years ago. You can't even remember.
I can. Did it hurt?
I think so. You cried like a baby.
I didn't.
Well, Peter certainly doesn't cry. Not even as Wendy stitches his shadow back on. One toe at a time.
Oh, I'm so clever. Did you know that I'm a genius?
And of course, I didn't do anything.
Don't be cross, Wendy. Everybody knows that one girl's worth 20 boys.
Just for that, you can have a kiss. Don't you know what a kiss is?
Well, I would if you gave me one. So now I suppose I have to give you a kiss in return.
It's lovely.
Tink? Where are you?
Wow, she's beautiful. What is she?
Tinkerbell is my fairy.
I wish she was mine. What did you say?
She said she's my fairy, and you're just a big, ugly girl.
Hey! Why are you here, Peter?
I come every night at bedtime to listen to your mother's stories.
I know lots of stories.
Come back to the Neverland with me, so the Lost Boys can hear them too.
Who are the Lost Boys?
The Lost Boys are boys who fall out of the prams when the mothers aren't paying attention.
Aren't there any lost girls?
Girls are far too clever to fall out of the prams.
That deserves a proper kiss. Ow! Tinkerbell just pulled my hair.
Yeah, she's a rather jealous type of fairy.
Where is the Neverland, Peter? And how do we get there?
We fly, of course. Wake up! We're flying to the Neverland.
Of course we are. How?
All you have to do is think of wonderful thoughts and they'll lift you up into the air.
Oh, and you'll need to be sprinkled with fairy dust, of course.
There's always a catch.
Can I come too?
course you can, Michael. We'd never leave without you.
Now all you have to do is believe. You have to really believe. To the Neverland. It has jungles and forests and mountains and mermaids and pirates.
Pirates? I love pirates. Which way?
Second to the right and straight on till morning.
What if we can't do it, Peter? Straight on till morning. Peter had told them the way to the Neverland, and the children knew that if the worst came to worst, all they had to do was go straight on, for the world was round. And so in time, they must surely come back to their own window.
Time to get some rest, you lot. We don't want you wearing yourselves out. Come on, let's go.
What's that, mate?
Come on, Woody.
It's only 7 o'clock,
boys. Teddy likes the story, especially the flying, and he wants to know what happens next.
Oh, it's your bedtime, darling. You're just going to have to dream about it, aren't you?
Mrs. Darling, I always feel sorry for having her kids fly away like that. Selfish little devils.
Aren't you too old for that?
I suppose so. But it's funny. And a bit sadder than I remember.
Hmm.
Is it still beating?
Your blood pressure's a bit lower than I would have liked. Nothing to worry about. Right.
Hello.
Hey.
Hmm.
I'm actually enjoying this.
Mm-hmm.
Tinkerbell's such a total bitch, though. Sorry.
Well, I saw a fairy once, when I was about your age. Small, perfect, and glowing like an angel. What?
There's no such things as fairies.
But you see, the universe is full of strange and wonderful stuff. Quarks, neutrinos, and dark matter. So why not fairies? See you.
Thank you. That was random.
Jolly Roger, captained by the villains James Hook.
I wish Nan was here.
The cruelest and most ruthless pirate of them all.
Is Hook worse than Captain Jack Sparrow?
Much worse. If he gets you on the Jolly Roger, you're lost forever.
There are children close by.
There are no children here, Captain. You boiled the last one in oil on Tuesday, remember?
It took forever to clean the pot.
Peter Pan, and he's bringing children with him. All hands on deck. Blow them out of the sky. Hook me.
Should we fire off a warning shot, Captain?
A warning shot! Oh, that's a good one, isn't it, Captain?
To fire!
This much.
This much.
A little less.
That much.
Educational standards were higher, my dear Mr. Speed. Back then, being a pirate was all about hard work. It was blood, sweat, and tears. Mainly blood.
I got an F on my entrance exam, Captain. They said it stood for fantastic.
Where are we?
What's that noise?
Those children landed nearby. Keep your eyes open, lads. Keep your eyes open.
All right, sweetheart.
Okay. Okay, he's coming.
It's all right. Fine. Call Mr. Wiley.
Oh, watch out.
I'm all right.
Mr. Mullins.
Yes, Captain.
My cravat. Something's not.
Yes. Sorry, Captain.
My dear fellow, pray don't concern yourself.
Say this for the captain. You always know where you stand. You might be dead, but you know where you stand.
He's hard, but very fair.
True. You will never have your last without good reason.
Even if he won't tell you what the reason is.
There you are, Captain. You could use those boots for a mirror.
Those boys are close. I can smell them. Mr. Smee, you're an idiot.
Thank you, Captain.
Pirates pass this way. This foot, he's hooked himself.
How can you tell?
I've seen something wonderful. A great bird flying this way. What kind of bird is that?
I don't know, but it looks like it's tired and it's moaning.
P wants us to shoot down Wendy, but
girl.
I shot her. Shot the Wendy bird.
Have you seen Wendy? She flew this way.
The Wendy's dead.
Who did this?
I did. Tinkerbell told me to do it.
Don't, Peter.
She's alive.
My kiss saved her life. You are no friend of mine, Tink. Leave me. Forever.
Don't banish her. Not forever, Peter. That would be too cruel.
All right. For a week, at least. Nibs, Tootles, carry her gently.
BP's returning to normal. All the other vital signs are good.
I'll be just stressed giving her a bad dream. It's a big day tomorrow.
She's a brave girl, but she's bound to be nervous.
Nothing to worry about. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Wiley.
What does it hurt?
My heart aches a little.
Wendy, will you be our mother?
Oh, I'm only a girl. I don't have the experience.
Well, all we really need is a nice, motherly person.
Well, I'm not going to be one of those mothers that sits at home worrying. I want to have adventures and kill pirates too.
That's just the kind of mother we need. Very loving and tender and bloodthirsty.
Yeah!
Well, as long as it's only pretend.
Captain! Captain! We captured one! A little savage.
Oh, what have we here?
An Indian boy, is it?
Shall we skin him alive? And eat his innards with peas and carrots?
Captain, I know we're pirates, but...
We do have standards.
Checo's a vegan. Bill Juice's got gluten allergy. And, I don't like carrots.
Take him to the ship! Princess Tiger Lily will pay dearly for one of her own.
It's me. It's Peter Pan I really want. It's he who cut off my hand.
Captain, I've often heard you say that your hook's worth a dozen hands, you know, for combing your hair and other such useful things.
True, true. If I were a mother, I'd pray to have my children born with hooks instead of hands.
So, in a roundabout way, Peter Pan did you a kindness.
He cut off my hand and tossed it to a passing crocodile. That dreadful creature liked it so much, it's hunted me ever since, hoping for the rest of me. But by lucky chance, it swallowed a clock as well. So before it can reach me, I hear the tick-tocking... And I flee.
One day that clock's gonna run down. And you're not gonna hear the crocodile coming.
Aye. One day. I will kill Pan, the strange smee. I will slaughter him and his infernal gang and feed their bodies to the dark waters from which no child ever returns.
Lovely. Welcome home.
Home? But there are no beds or chairs.
And no door.
John, you're about two this size. You can use his toy.
Come on.
Michael.
Tree.
You can follow Curly.
Yeah.
Wendy?
Yeah.
Come with me. If you breathe in, you should be all right.
Ah!
And so, brave Cinderella crept down into the crypt where the giant spiders lived. She opened the coffin lid with a creak and drove the sharpened wooden heel of her slipper through the wicked vampire's heart. And he shriveled into dust and disappeared forever.
Well, what about the handsome prince? Does he come back from the grave and try to suck Cinderella's blood?
Cinderella gave the Prince Charming a gentle kiss and some cod liver oil. And he woke from the undead feeling much better. So, when she dusted him down a bit, they got married and had lots of children who became fearless vampire hunters as well.
Were they all boys like us?
Some, but there were girls too. And they were the bravest of all.
Knew it'd turn out all right in the end.
All right. Bedtime now, children. You do. Good night.
Oh, it's disgusting.
No, it's not. Go on. Good night, boys. I suppose you must get lonely sometimes.
You're here now.
Peter, I have to go home one day.
Why? You can stay here and play. John can learn to hunt and Michael can fly his kite all day. Your mother and father will soon forget about you.
Always keep the nursery window open for us.
No, they'll close and lock it and forget you're ever born.
And so it was that the poor, defenseless boy was carried off from his home at the age of only 6 years old. And he was sent to one of the most brutal and savage institutions ever devised for the torture of young children.
Was it Newgate Prison?
Right, the House of Correction.
Was he hanging chains at execution dock?
No, it was much worse than that, lad. He was sent to Eton College.
Oh, that's horrible. Oh,
makes me shiver to think on it.
What's Eton College?
A hellish dungeon by the sounds of it.
You've got that right, Starkey. The lumpy porridge. The chillblains,
so blind.
The parsing of irregular Latin verbs. Bennett James Hook, poor, innocent child.
He's got the same name as you, Captain.
It is me, you idiot. My mother! Why did you ever send me away?
Is that why you're a black-hearted villain, Captain? Because your mother didn't love you?
My mother did love me! Does any man here say different? I hope that our guest is uncomfortable and has had nothing at all to eat nor drink.
Oh, we're making his life thoroughly miserable, Captain, just as you ordered.
Your mother would be ashamed of you.
Shall we kill all him, Captain? Or shall we slice him into tiny pieces?
Yeah.
And post him home in an envelope.
I like your thinking, Jack, my boy, but we need him as bait. See, soon my trap will be set. And oh, then I will kill you, Peter Pan, and my revenge will taste sweeter than honey!
You gave us quite a scare, young lady.
I was dreaming.
What about?
Nothing much. I want to go swimming this morning.
Absolutely not.
I won't ever do it. Cross my heart, hope to...
Perhaps another time.
What if there is no other time? What if this is my last chance? Ever?
Is there something that you want to ask me about this operation, Lucy?
What if something goes wrong and I don't wake up? What if I die?
The chances of that happening are very, very remote. See you this afternoon.
You're gonna be just fine.
How do you know? We've not yet decided which adventure to narrate. We might tell how Peter Pan saved Tiger Lily's life in the Mermaid's Lagoon, and so made her his ally. Or perhaps a better story would be the night attack by the Indians on the house under the ground.
Wait a minute. Indians?
It actually says Redskins, but I don't think that's a very nice word anymore.
So, can it be any kind of Indians?
I don't see why not.
We can live with that, can't we?
Sorry, I have to go now.
I can read it. I'll stick it back in your room later, gosh. He's enjoying it?
A princess in her own right, proud and beautiful, a chief's daughter. And if she must die as a chief's daughter, it is enough.
Release my brother or die!
Drop it. The boy goes over the side.
It's me you want. Let my brother go.
All right, Mr. Smee. Let the boy go.
Shall I row him to shore, Captain?
Mr. Smee, I sometimes wonder if you're quite cut out to be a pirate. No! Throw the little brat overboard. He's fish food now!
Sorry, mate.
No!
Boss wants what the boss wants.
Lovely little spearman, don't you think?
No! Hook gave the signal and the carrion was cast overboard. There was a splash and then silence. A change came to the lagoon and little shivers ran over it.
All right, mate.
Told of Maruna's Rock, so called because evil captains put sailors on it to drown when the tide came in. But sometimes mermaids would be playing in the lagoon, and they were quite a pretty sight. You must not think from this that the mermaids were friendly. On the contrary.
Mermaids have the brains of a halibut. They don't understand that we can't breathe underwater.
Your last chance, my pretty. Tell me where Peter Pan's hideout is, or I'll leave you on this rock to drown when the tide comes in.
I will never betray Peter Pan. I would rather die than let you harm a single hair from his beautiful head.
Tiger Lily loves me like a brother.
Very touching, my dear. And a better man than I would let you go.
There ain't a better man than you sailing the seven seas, Captain.
Fair point, Mr. Smee, thank you. Well, she's made her choice. Let her drown.
A lesson she won't soon forget.
Don't worry, Missy. Could be worse.
Imagine if the captain didn't like you.
It's me. I fear the game is up, Smee. Those boys have found a mother, whilst poor Hook has no one to tuck him in at night.
I mean, we could kidnap their mother and make her our own, maybe.
Princeless scheme, Smee. But we'll make her our mother and make those boys walk the plank. Give me a hand. Oh, sorry.
I will never be your mother.
What?
Save yourself, Tiger Lily.
No! I will fight by the side of the great warrior Peter Pan and avenge my fallen brother.
Your brother lives, Tiger Lily. He needs you. Go!
Now we have him, Mr. Smee. Now we have him.
Slipped. Wouldn't be fair.
Good show, old boy.
You bit me!
Peter!
going now?
Mr. Smee, on the boat, quickly! Oh, no! The crocodile, it's coming! Hurry, Smee!
Faster!
Hurry! Row!
Faster!
Row!
We used a bulky ball. Left! Left!
Hurry up!
Left, right!
Captain!
Captain, I can't swim!
Where were you?
I went swimming. Mr. Wiley said it was okay.
Really? Nurse Doyle was looking for
Mom,
you.
Mum, don't make a fuss.
A girl brought this back for you.
Yeah, that's Tiger Lily. She's in love with Peter, but he doesn't know it.
She said her name was Jaya. Are you all right?
Mum? Mum, the tide's coming in. I'm drowning.
Lucy?
Frightened, Peter.
Guy, it'd be an awfully big adventure. An awfully big adventure. An awfully big adventure.
It's Michael's kite. Carries back to the mainland.
You go. It's not strong enough for the bones.
No. Peter, I'm not leaving without you.
Just take it.
No!
Take it.
No!
Wendy, take it. You must. It'll save you.
Mrs. Ross, I will tell you the moment there's any news.
Hello, Lucy. You're a little ahead of schedule.
He can...
Huh?
He can use his hook.
She said you can use your hook.
Lucy. Lucy. Can you count to 20 for me, Lucy?
3 children called Wendy, John, and Michael Darling, who flew away to the Neverland, where they had many adventures. But they never forgot their real home, and always knew that one day they would leave the Neverland behind and fly back to it.
What did their home look like?
Have you forgotten it already, Michael? Surely you remember Mother at least.
You are Mother.
What about Father? And Nana?
Didn't Nana work in a bank?
No, that's Father. We must talk about Mother and Father every day so that we never forget them.
I hate this story.
It is very sad. I don't see how it can end well.
That's because you don't know how great is a mother's love. The children always knew that the mother would keep a window open. When it was time to come home.
You're wrong about mothers. It's a lie.
BP is low.
What is it, Peter?
What's wrong?
My mother was just like yours. She promised she'd always keep a window open, but when I did go back, the window was closed. There was another little boy sleeping in my bed. My mother had forgotten all about me. You're the only mother I want now.
That's only pretend, Peter. I have to go home one day. I don't belong in the Neverland. Not forever.
Why not? I want you to stay.
Peter, what are your exact feelings for me? Can't you say?
Tiger Lily's just like you. She wants to be something to me, but I don't know what. What is it girls want?
That's not for me to say.
Tinkerbell will tell me that.
I'm sure she will. I think we all know what kind of fairy she is.
A house under a tree. How devilishly cunning.
Oh, they were looking to find a tree with a house underneath it.
Pan built the house, idiot. Your time has come, Peter Pan.
BP 40 over 20, output dropping.
Would you like me to sit with you?
No, she's not tolerating this well. I'm administering adrenaline.
Michael and I want to go home.
And I'd like to come too, if there's room.
I'm sure I can ask Mother and Father to adopt you.
And me?
And me!
Yeah, me.
All right. Curly.
All of you.
Haven't you had fun here, Tootles? Or you, Nibs?
Can't play forever. It's not real life.
Real life's for grown-ups. It's a trap.
Couldn't our mother and father adopt Peter as well?
I don't want your silly mother and father. I want to stay here having adventures forever.
Childhood has to end one day.
No, it doesn't. Never has to end. Go then. But once you leave the Neverland, you can never come back.
Won't you at least say goodbye, Peter? Promise me you'll take your medicine every night.
Peter!
Time for your medicine, Peter Pan.
Mother. Pretty mother. Waiting. Should have never let them go alone. Come on, Tink. Let's rescue them. Wait. I'd better drink my medicine first, otherwise Wendy will get angry. Poison. You must have dreamt it. Hook couldn't possibly fit down here. Tink! It was poisoned. You sacrificed yourself to save me, but why? You can't die, Tink. You can't. Maybe you'd get better again if children believed in fairies, but they do, Tink. They do. No, you're wrong. I'm sure they do. They have to. They must.
I believe.
So do I.
I do.
I believe.
I believe.
Me too.
Fairies. Come on. All right. I believe. Gosh. Do not tell my mates.
We're losing output. Very high CO2. She's arrested. Shocking.
I was reading her book, and one of the legends about Peter Pan is that when children die, Peter goes part of the way with them so they won't be frightened.
A comforting thought, perhaps, yeah.
Is my daughter going to die?
Shocking. No change.
Come on, Lucy. All right, go ahead. Go.
We have output back. BP 40 over 20. 50 over 30. 80 over 50. CO2 good.
Okay. Good. Good work, everybody.
in fairies.
Life. Children do believe. They do. Now to rescue Wendy. Talk on me this time.
Or I will fillet you from head to toe. It's cruel to mock. Really? Injures a fella's feelings?
Well, we're very sorry, Mr. Smee.
And it's good of you to say so.
Then perhaps you might let us go now?
No, the captain wouldn't understand. He wants to hear a joke.
Why do they find Smee so lovable and not old Hooky? Poor Hook. No little children to love him.
Mr. Smee! Bring those wretched brats on deck.
Try as you weevil, you'll feel the kiss of my hook.
Now, six of you will walk the plank tonight. But I have room for two cabin boys on my crew. Who is it to be?
Don't think my mother would want me to be a pirate.
Mine wouldn't either. And my mother wants me to be an accountant. It's a steady career with a nice pension.
Oh, quiet! Accountant? Can't have any accountants on the Jolly Roger. Get the mother ready. She'll go first. They won't be so brave then. Come on! Silence!
For a mother's last words to her children.
Boys, I feel I have a message to you. From your real mothers. It is this. We hope our sons die like true English gentlemen.
If I save you, will you be my mother?
I'd rather have no children at all than adopt a pirate.
Well, if she won't be our mother, then she won't be anyone's. Make her walk the plank, boys!
Crocodile's gone.
Come on!
I have
have an idea, lads. I wonder if these boys would like a touch of the cat before they go to Davy Jones' locker. Get the girl! I want her to be a witness.
We don't have a cat, Captain. What, leeches and rats, maybe?
No, I mean the cat of nine tails. The whip! Mason, go and fetch it from the mess. Come on. Oh, I love the sound of children crying in the morning. It sounds like victory. Check here. Go and see what's the matter. Come on.
My son's dead. There's something terrible in there.
Go and fetch it out.
Whatever it is, it's not natural.
Is this mutiny, Checker?
No,
I think I heard you volunteer to go next, Bill Jukes.
Oh, never.
The hook thinks you did. I think it would be wise to humor the hook, don't you? No. There's a Jonah on board, lads, that brings the evil with it. I have a notion. Open up that door and drive these boys in. If they kill the Jonah, we're so much the better. If he kills them, we're none the worse. Come on, get in there, boys! Get them all! Come on, get up, you! Luck.
Oh, that is true. Everybody knows that. Women, you know?
What's the point in them?
You.
No one can save you now, Missy.
There's one.
Who?
Peter Pan, the Avenger!
Ah!
to be careful.
Bedford, you know I can't fly.
Then I won't either.
All right. A fair fight to the death, Peter Pan. Just you and me.
Agreed. How about you, dark and sinister villain?
Now, there's no need for name-calling. It's very hurtful.
Sorry.
It's all right.
Who and what are you, Peter Pan?
I'm you! I'm Joy! I'm innocent!
Stand back, or I'll show this girl the road to dusty death.
But that's not fair!
Only fools and children fight fair, Peter Pan. To pieces. We'll die avenged, Mr. Smee.
Very comforting, Captain.
Peter Pan will save us.
Not this time, Missy.
Look, behind you.
Oh, come on. You don't think old Hooky is going to fall back?
Made us work very hard, but the operation was a complete success.
I'm not going to die.
Oh, Lord, no. You have at least another 60, 70 years in that heart.
Mr. Wiley.
Mm-hmm.
Not sure for the crocodile.
I will.
It's okay. I don't want to forget how to fly.
Now return to that desolate home from which three of our characters took flight
so long ago. On that eventful night, Mrs. Darling was in the nursery. All the gaiety of her in the old days has gone because she has lost her children.
I know, it's cold, Nana. Don't ask me to close the window. It must always be left open for them. I dreamt my beloved children would come back. Nana. I'm still dreaming now.
Mother!
Wendy?
I missed you so much.
Wendy? Mother!
Wendy! Darling woke to share her bliss, and there could not have been a lovelier sight. But there was none there to see it, except a strange boy. Peter Pan had ecstasies innumerable that other children could never know.
This is Curly.
But he was looking at the one joy from which he must be forever barred.
Would you like to live with us? Would you? All right then, I think. But you have to promise me to take a bath. You take a bath.
Sorry, I have to leave soon.
What?
I'm coming home.
Come on.
Can you tell us what happens at the end?
Come on. Nana's going to bath you. Nana's a dog.
To the bar.
Let's go.
Come on.
Mother will adopt you too. You'll be like her own son.
Would I have to go to school? Go to work in an office and get married?
I suppose so. One day.
Keep back a lady. Nobody's gonna catch me and make me a man.
Wait, where are you going?
Back to the Neverland.
But you'll be so lonely.
Not if you come with me.
I can't. Peter, I want to. So much, but I can't.
Why are you crying?
I don't know.
Second to the right, and straight until morning.
Don't forget me, Peter.
I should hope so. It's your bag.
All set, Lucy?
Mm-hmm.
Great. So we're going to keep you under observation for a little while, okay? But you shouldn't have any further problems. So go out and enjoy yourself.
I mean within reason.
Well, this is goodbye, Mrs. Rose.
I can never thank you enough.
You don't ask him, I will.
Ask me what?
I just thought... I was wondering if you maybe drink coffee.
Yes, and tea.
That's wonderful. Maybe we could drink coffee or tea together sometime. I mean, without the annoying brat hanging around.
Yeah. Sadly, that's not a possibility, because the General Medical Council takes a very dim view of such things, and their rules are very clear. So, sorry. But if circumstances were different, we would drink coffee all day.
Super embarrassing, Mum.
Your daughter is going to grow up to be a fine young woman someday. I do believe that. So take good care of her, Mrs. Rose.
I will.
Okay.
I will.
All right. Bye.
Thank you, Mr. Wendy.
You're welcome, Lucy.
Thank you.
Bye, Mrs. Rose. Bye. Bye now. Bye.
Bye,
bye Lucy.
Look.
Bye. Bye, guys.
All right, come on. Patients aren't going to cure themselves. Come on. Let's go.
Still got it.
All right. That's enough.
You're fake.
Yeah.
It's about time then. Put myself out there again.
Bye, Mrs. Rose.
There's this nice man in the office who keeps asking me out for a drink. Maybe I'll take him up on it.
Good plan, Mum. Only no losers or widows.
Deal. I spoke to your father, by the way. He's flying back tonight, and I've invited him for dinner at the weekend. I promise to be good. He's your dad, after all.
Thanks, Mum. Can you wait here just 1 second? Thanks. Sorry about Hanif.
He liked your story.
It's not really mine.
Too old for that.
Shut up.
In a few months' time, I will be begging for hugs. Mom,
stop. Don't be weird.
Tomorrow evening, an ambush awaits Jekyll and Hyde at 7, and there's more brand new drama after that at 9. Scandal is never far away from Harry Price, Ghost Hunter. Next this Boxing Day evening, though, with Coldplay and Sir Ian McKellen, it's a Christmas special of The Jonathan Ross Show.